Hey guys, it's back. Help, it's again. It's the Poltergeist 5000 back from Bloodstained. In the last episode, we did a bunch of faffing around and didn't really accomplish a whole lot. In between episodes, I did a little bit of grinding off screen. For what exactly, I've kind of forgotten. I got apples. I got stuff to make a smoothie, although I actually ended up not needing to, because those Tomoko deaths, the guitarist, rock star girl demons in the library, they can actually drop smoothies. So I ended up getting one from that. And what else did I get? I had a notepad document open with everything, but I closed it because I had everything, but now I don't remember what I was gonna make. How stupid is that? So yeah, sure, but okay, we can make the op. So that's good, we can make op. What other drinks do we have? Apple juice, we already made. Limonade for the day. I don't know. I guess we'll just, we'll just drop by here. I'll pick up a. Wait, did I already give you the thing? Did I already give you your lemonade? Oh, yeah! I got a pork cutlet! I got one. I grinded the bloom parmas for another one. It's pretty. It happened pretty quick, thankfully, so here you go. That's it! We got doji giri, because I got some boskoth! Yellow one looks like it tastes like a cloud. I think we already have that. Is that just sponge? No, it's an omelet! do we have what we need to make an omelet? I don't think we have what we need to make an omelet. You pushed the wrong button! I'm playing Octopath Traveler on this controller using, like, a Super Nintendo button layout. So I'm used to B being confirm. Or I'm used to the right button being confirmed, because I have to put the letters out of my mind when I play SNES games on an Xbox controller. Okay, what am I looking for? I'm looking for to make... do I even have that? Egg souffle, okay. But I should be able to buy that. And we're gonna let's drink that. Let's drink this apple juice and this smoothie. So now we have 4 MP quick charge per second, which means every second we regenerate 4 MP. And that actually also means that, essentially, anything that consumes MP over time, you know, like Bunny Morphosis only costs 5 MP to maintain every second. So by taking advantage of that, by cranking your stuff up higher, you can completely negate... I think you can get up to and over 5 MP quick charge. I don't remember exactly. Egg souffle. Misericorde! And now you want silky and sweet. What is that? What is that?
I can't see what that is. It looks like a cake.
I mean, I guess we'll go see. Oh, and before, and while we do, we'll go talk to... you. Hello. Miriam. Oh, right, the silk dress. Yeah, okay. So we can't do that yet. So, what is it we're looking for? We're looking for something silky and smooth, or sweeter, or whatever. It looked like a cake. I'll see it when I'm in the corner there. It's chiffon cake. Which we can buy. I hate how easy it is to miss those with this, with a spear. It's a pain in the ass. Okay, so we're gonna buy. Don't worry, guys. We will get to exploring more. We're gonna explore the underwater reservoir in this video. I'm just wanna get these out of the way. Chiffon cake, Fangshi scarf. Wait, didn't I have the option to make that? Well, if it didn't lower my luck, I'd put it on. You know what? Maybe I'll put it on anyway. Oh, I can't. I can't deny my one true love, the luck up. What next? Juicy on the inside, crispy on the outside. What is that?
What is that?
Crispy on the outside, juicy on the inside. That sounds like it'll be easy for me to identify. Usually, the description she gives you will match. Certain parts of it will match the description of the item in the menu here, so it's pretty easy to... It's really hard to make out what she's actually... It's really hard to make out what's actually there. Like, in the picture. It's not fried fish. I don't think it's that. It's not simmered Fornia's, because that's not crispy on the outside. It could be this. I don't think so, though. The smell clings to your garments. Oh my god, that is a mood. That is the thing I hate most about cooking.
What is that?
Okay, it's got red on top and it's got green thing on the side. It looks like it's got mistletoe on top of it. How many things could there possibly be that have both of those things? I don't believe I have the recipe for that yet. No, I definitely don't. Okay. Then in that case, I think it's high time we actually made our way over. It's right here. We're going right there. That's not what I meant to do. We're going right there. And we're just gonna... Ooh, nice. 300 gold in the bank. You'll love to see it. Limonade for any. The pain. Oh my god, it hurts so badly. No. Get out of here. You're a bastard. I'm gonna make sure I keep hitting these things, because that's good money we're getting there. Like, can I get up there? No, that's an ammo upgrade. We aren't gonna be able to get that for a while. Man, remember this area? It's been a while since we've, Good lord. Okay. So my game plan is we're going to pass through all the same corridors here with this in the hopes that, well, that didn't quite work the way I wanted it to. I was kind of hoping that I would actually hit some of those enemies so that I could practice my, I know what would work better there would be if I just waited for the bats to move into position. Okay, you're... Yeah. Oh, and I can go backwards for them, too, because it's so fast. I can't believe this movie has existed this whole time. Get back here. I'm going to kick your ass. Toad? You too. What the heck? A mort. I don't know why I said muert. The heck, dude? Ah, they're going up. Shoot. How much is that going up by? That's gonna be a tricky one to level up, actually. Parry. Parry! Parry! Thrust! Parry! Parry! Thrust! Wait, do I already have that mastered? No, here we go. Yeah. Yeah, that indeed looks like it's gonna take a while to... Excuse me! To master. Which is good, because, well... Actually, it's less than good, because I would like to master it soon, so that I can use it while I'm running around. You know, like I kidnapped the princess while you were... Alright, while you were running around. Alright, Miriam. Show us your party trick. Schlorp. My god, you got a lot of capacity. You drank that whole thing up. Alright. Now we can finally explore... Well, finally. We didn't know this was here until, like, now. Like, we didn't... We, like, there was nothing... Miriam didn't know that this gap was here. She just saw a pool full of blood and was like, I want that in me right now. So. Doo-doo. Oh, no, it's an axe outsider. Ow. You little... No, come on. Oh, you can actually bump into the same enemy over and over again if you just hold the button down. That's worth that. That's worth remembering. Hey, dude. Dude! Why can't I hit that? Oh my god! Okay, that works out really well, actually. That's probably gonna be the way to do that. Yeah, sure enough. Those last two enemies were like a fifth of the... It brought us like a fifth of the way there. Well, brought us another fifth of the way there, I should say. Not gonna be able to use that on you. I'll just get you out of here. You're gonna die, thank you. Oh man, we still have to kill six of those guys because they decided to give me that after they became available. And look how much money we're getting from these. Dang it. I missed. Where at? Oh, you know what? I know where this is. This is coming back to the other side of the area that we visited briefly. Nice. Fried fish! Oh, you actually need to do something here, too. This is one of the most mind-bending things they actually require you to do. Oh, that's not it. Hang on. Yeah, it's not you. It's another enemy. You actually need to, in order to explore this area, you actually need a specific random drop. Like, you need a specific soul from an enemy in here to, like, explore this entire area, and the only way to get it is to literally grind it off of the enemy that drops it. And it's really wild. Like, I got stuck here for the longest time when I first played this, because, like, there was literally nothing to suggest that that's how you would have to do this. Frogs. Annoying. Water leaper. What is this? Oh, I already knew that. I didn't need you to tell me that. I need to master that, like, right quick so that I have access to it later. I don't need to save. I'm doing just fine. Well, I probably should save, just in case. Don't have to do all that side questing again if I die. You know, found out here if I die. That actually is the name of an episode. Because for the longest time I thought I was misremembering that, but now that actually isn't the name of an episode. It's the name of the Mother... It's the name of one of the episodes of Tim's Mother 3 LP. In Chapter 7. Right after... Because he cliffhanged at the end of the last episode, and so he named the next one. Like, it's like, find out here if I die, but it's found out here. It's like, what? Are you drunk? Oh man, another huge room like this. Ain't nobody got time for that. Rose ring and platinum. What does the rose ring do? The rose ring. Oh, it increases the amount restored by mana roses. Cute. Oh. Maggie. Cute. Y'all. Do I hear something over here? I thought I heard an axe outsider. Did I? Why is this room so damn long? Oh my god. Aha. You thought my head was for the bouncing. Critical ring. I already had that. Okay, whatever. Don't matter. It don't matter. It's a bit sad how, like, much luck is obviously the most important stat, because it basically means that if you want to play the game like properly, if you want to 100% the game like properly, without it taking like 5 million years. you kind of have to, like, ignore, like, half the gear. I mean, you really don't. It's just, that's how I like to play it. But I do feel a little bit sad about missing out on so much stuff. Jeez, man. That's a really good move. It's good for getting around, and it's actually good offensively, too. Nice lighting in there. Pretty. Man, this area is a lot more expansive, like, early on than I remember it being. What the hell? Oh yeah, you do have wings, don't you? Gotcha! Got ya! Ooh, ooh, ooh! Nice! What is that? Is this, augment... Oh, it's Words of Wisdom, reduces MP consumption. Cool. Oh, man, you know what? Oh, man, that reminds me. That reminds me of something completely irrelevant, but I just watched a stream I'm looking forward to later this week. I'm not even gonna bother pointing it out. Well, you know what? You know, yeah, I am. Later this week, Fauna is finishing Faith, the Unholy Trilogy, or whatever that game's called, and I just watched the first stream, and I'm really looking forward to it, because it was really fun. You should check it out. Jeez. Good lord. You know, there is such a thing as being too vloggy in an LP. You know, I'm usually one to parade around, you know, that vlogginess is a good thing in LPs, but there is such a thing as going too far with it when you just start talking about random bullshit that has nothing to do with anything. Here we go. It's you. This guy. And you can see they propel themselves, and there it is. You actually need this soul. Aqua Stream allows you to swim by launching water in the opposite direction. An MP is not consumed while you're underwater. You actually need this shard to continue exploring this area. I'm not even kidding. Like, you actually need it. And you know what? I'm gonna put that on a shortcut. So now we can move around underwater by forcing ourselves to move versus in the opposite direction. So as if it wasn't weird enough that you have to get a specific soul just to explore this area, you need to do it backwards too, because the controls are reversed, because you're pushing yourself with the stream. Oh, there's more places to go. So many toys to play with! Yeah, thank God it doesn't consume MP underwater, because that would have been such a pain in the ass. What's up here? Anything? No? No? Okay. If you say so. So... No. Do the thing. Dang it! Carabas! I was about to finish him off! With my mighty shot! With my mighty spear! There's actually some pretty scary navigation puzzles in this area. You need to navigate with this. Oh, you know, we can't even open this. You can't open chests unless you can stand on the ground. Which I guess makes some amount of sense. I mean, I would probably have trouble manipulating a chest to open it if I was underwater, and like my buoyancy was pushing me upwards. But still, what a pain in the ass. It won't be too long before we gain the ability to keep exploring there, though. Man, I gotta go all the way back. Because this just goes over to that area where we found Benjamin. The waterfall, which there's nothing else to do over there as far as I know. There might be like a breakable wall or something, but Dumping and chunking on the can. Why are there bats, like, everywhere? Like... Yeah, and these are also the enemies that we need for the, These are also... These are the Decimas that we need for one of the bounties, if you recall. Oh my god, fighting down here is such a pain in the ass. You don't want to charge directly into them, but... Ooh, what did you drop? These guys have some good drops. Those guys can actually drop a really powerful short sword. A pretty powerful. I don't know if I'd say it's really powerful, but it's pretty strong. It's called Iamur. You might recall that we saw it. I believe we saw it in the ingredients for a stronger sword at Johannes in the crafting menu. That was pretty well handled. I'm surprised I didn't crash head. Okay, this is where things get a little bit dangerous. You need to start. You start having to navigate through like spike gauntlets, and they do a lot of damage. Because if you recall, if you've played Inkavania games before, you probably know that you know spike traps generally do percentage damage. So they always do. Scyllas, I remember, being important for some reason, but I don't recall exactly why. They have pretty upsetting damage sounds, though. Ugh. Ooh, what's that? MP Max. Nice. I don't know. It's confusing because like, you have to, like, it's confusing to attack and move. Because like you have to do it in the opposite, or else it is absolutely painful to come through here and not be able to pick any of this shit up. What else is annoying is that even once you get the ability to walk around underwater, it's slow as molasses. Oh, but here we are, onto a new area. This is a cool area and an important area for grinding, because this is the best place to grind for Alkahest. The Hidden Desert. In fact, it's right here, I believe, is the spot where I usually do it. These Amies, that's what those enemies are called. They have a chance to drop two Alkahest as opposed to the one Alkahest that the ghosts drop. And this room right here has two of them in a row. In fact, I think there's actually four of these in here. There's also a scary dragon, though. Oh my god, that is so cool. That is so much fun to do. Just hold the button down and just bounce into him. I was actually staying out of the quicksand too. I don't remember what happens if you get sucked down there. If you get sent into like a Meridia-esque little progression of rooms or something. But yeah. I don't remember what all there is good to get in here besides those. Besides grinding for Alkahest, I don't recall. I'm sure there's gotta be some stuff, though. There's mahogany, that's good money. Oh, there's another, yeah, look, here's the second kind of succubus. Oh my god, that does a lot of damage. Yeah! Okay, whatever. I'm taking a beating. Do I have any food that I've yet to eat? I don't need to worry about this anymore because now that we fought, because of those Fornius guys, the many-headed fish, they drop the Fornius fillets that you use to make fish dishes. Wrong button, jackass. I gotta get that Egyptian chanting. That reminds me so much of the music of that song that the Yogscast used to play in like their archaeological. In the archaeological adventure maps that they would do. Oh my god. Forgot you could do that. Oh yeah. Oh, hello. You're scary. Nice, you mastered the technique. Now I can switch off this. Now I can switch off this weapon. Now I can use. Now, more importantly, I can use that with any. Pretty good. Man, you're strong. Rough. Rough biz. Okay, so what else we got? What other techniques we have to master? I'm gonna go until we find a save point down here, and then we'll end the episode off. Rapid fire, we still need to master. Force blast. Parry! Parry! Thrust! What sword is that with? Do we have that in our journal? Because I don't remember finding that. Ah, shoot. I must have accidentally used it with some random weapon. And then it showed up in my techniques, but I don't remember where. Well, you know what? In that case, let's switch out one of those new weapons that we got. We got a couple new things. We got Misericordia. Does this have a force blast? No. It doesn't seem to have any moves. Oh, you know what I keep forgetting to do? You can make a new pair of shoes. We can actually make something with these toy shoes. You can make bunny shoes. Which is just so hilariously... Oh my god. I don't know why my controller has been doing that. I hope that's a problem with the cord and not like this is a faulty controller, because there is a slight defect, like physical defect in the D-pad that already drives me nuts. Well, you know what, let's just... No, that's the wrong button! Oh my god! What about Blutgun? Wait, how did I do that? How do I do that? Force blast. It's quarter circle forward. Okay, what? Oh my god. This is so stupid. Force blast. Alright, whatever. Let's just go. I want to use Misericord because it looks cool. I like the sound it makes. Does that do holy damage? That'd be cool. I don't know if that would actually be more effective. This game isn't as ubiquitous. Like, Castlevania Aria of Sorrow, for example. Ow. In Castlevania Aria of Sorrow, for example, holy weapons are unambiguously, like, fucking overpowered as hell because everything in Castlevania is vulnerable to demon magic. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's literally the in-universe justification, explanation for why holy water lights the ground on fire. Is because Castlevania is, like, inherently demonic and reacts violently to holy water in and of itself. Oh, hey, a dog. I'm surprised we haven't seen these guys yet. Oh, no, we saw one of them. Yeah, the dogs look a little more different from each other. Than most enemy palette swaps. Ah, my nose. My nose hairs are giving me hell. Itchy. Why am I so itchy? Oh my god, hi! Unfortunately, these guys don't really give a shit about piercing damage, as you would probably expect from, you know... Skeletons generally tend to not, you know, be super bothered by piercing damage. Oh, man, really? I was hoping that would not be... I had a fairy potion? That's news to me. Where is this? Are we out of the hidden desert already? Wait, where does this go back? Oh, we're back in here. Can I have a warp? I want a warp. Oh, my god. I don't want to end the episode in the middle of buttfuck nowhere, but... A warp! Oh, my god! Ha! Well, what do you know? Alright, cool. Well, in that case, why don't we end this episode right here? Next time on Bloodstained Symphony... No, Ritual of the Night. I reckon... Oh, I didn't fill any of those. No, I did. Wait, did I?
Here's what I've turned up on the monster.
Yeah, I did do the archdemons. Okay, good.
Here's what I've turned up on the monsters.
Lamash 2, Living Fossil. Yeah, these are both really close. Next time. Next time we will continue exploring the hidden desert and the underground, forbidden underground waterway or whatever the fuck it's called. And I'll see you then. Bye.